You want men.
Are you?
See, this interview, she's a local, yeah?
Hey, you know what? You're drunk.
You know what, mother...
Excuse me?
Yeah,
excuse me? The police.
Call them right now. Call them now and find out.
Get the f*** out of here. They're not allowed here. Yeah? You know what? You're gonna be...
You know what? I asked your opinion because I'm not helping. No, you're honest in your video. Tell me. You and me can go f*** each other. My girl, she's not disturbing anyone. And you know what? I bet she loves to make friends with people. She's a loving creature and you're not. So why don't you go back to China where you grew up?
You're in China.
I just said go back to China.
You're in China.
Sorry.
So what is happening here, we are on, she wants to get on a bus. She has a dog. Someone's like, you can't bring the dog on the bus. And so she tells them to go back to China, even though she's in China. I have more information on this, John, but what's your initial reaction?
I don't, so they said she was drunk. I assume she must have been. They pointed out we're in China and she doubled down saying, no, I said go back to China. She really, is it just like a, you know, a gunslinger hears a loud noise and instantly goes for the pistol? It's just her go-to and she can't like make it context appropriate? How could you roll that out as your insult? Why would a woman this fundamentally racist be on a trip in China in the first place? What is going on, Brett?
I will give you the key that unlocks just a whole other level of enjoying this. She's in Hong Kong, which is China now, but it wasn't always thanks to British colonialism. And okay. No, you cannot bring your dog on the bus in Hong Kong unless it's a guide dog. But she is really showing off how great she is at a person. It's like he would be friends with you because he's a loving spiritual creature. At the beginning, the reason you didn't understand it is because she was speaking Chinese. So she knows really? It. She is territorially, in my interpretation of the event, saying, go back to mainland China, stay out of Kowloon. But the only loon there is that cow.
Now that's inappropriate.
Here's another pun. Shishi is crazy. Mgoy?
Oh my God. Stop. No. Anyway, okay. So there are some stereotypes about racists. There are some stereotypes about like, you know, sort of racism, and apparently one of like the biggest, one of the biggest predictors of someone being a conservative is whether they own a passport or not. Like you generally think of these people as being close-minded, not having expanded their borders literally or the boundaries of their mind. But at the end of the day, that's almost like a comfort. It's weird to have someone traveling the world, speaking the language, and still being like seemingly as close-minded in the moment. I don't want that. I want the consistent sort of stereotypical racist. I don't like cosmopolitan racism nearly as much.
Yeah, and she also has like an American accent. So she's not even British being like, this was a bad deal we set up. It's like she's exactly, American that in Hong
might have
Kong.
Been justified.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.